Unreal. Obama going on major overseas tour to sabotage Trump. Look who he's meeting. Barack Obama is planning a tour across Asia just weeks after President Trump returned, and who he's planning to meet with should have Americans enraged. If you remember, when President Trump first went to Europe, Obama followed in his shadows and met with the same world leaders right after the president did. While we don't know the full extent of Obama's conversations with them, we do know that Obama has repeatedly promised to be a subversive force for the Trump administration and its agenda, so we can safely assume his meeting dealt with the preservation of Obama's foreign policy initiatives. Unfortunately, those initiatives weren't in America's interests, which means they're the exact opposite of President Trump's, but that doesn't seem to be stopping Americans' worst P resident from tailing our new leader and trying to undermine his agenda, the Daily Wire reported. In fact, Obama's upcoming trip to Asia has him meeting with the same leaders President Trump recently met with, again bringing into question his motive for traveling overseas. From the Daily Wire. The shadow president, apparently concerned that his successor will somehow make the results of Obama-era foreign policy worse, will visit China's president and make an extra stop in India, potentially as a way of countering any Trump-related damage there. First daughter Ivanka is in India this week promoting educational initiatives for girls. Per The Hill, Obama is undertaking the trip as part of his Obama Foundation kickoff tour, and he'll spend a few days in Shanghai where he'll meet with President Xi Jinping before jetting to New Delhi and then to Paris, where he'll meet with French officials. The trip is probably not a coincidence. Shortly after Donald Trump made his first trip abroad as president, visiting Italy and France as well as several other nations, Obama just happened to schedule follow-up trips where he visited many of the same nations and dined privately with leaders who'd spoken to Trump just days before. While this may seem innocuous to some, keep in mind that Obama has been scheming to undermine Trump from the get-go. First, it was using our intelligence agencies to spy on his campaign. Then once Trump won the election, Obama set up shop right down the street from the White House to run his own shadow government, the New York Post reported. In what's shaping up to be a highly unusual post-presidency, Obama isn't just staying behind in Washington. He's working behind the scenes to set up what will effectively be a shadow government to not only protect his threatened legacy, but to sabotage the incoming administration and its popular America First agenda. He's doing it through a network of leftist nonprofits led by Organizing for Action. Normally you'd expect an organization set up to support a politician and his agenda to close up shop after that candidate leaves office, but not Obama's offense. Rather, it's gearing up for battle, with a growing war chest and more than 250 offices across the country. Since Donald Trump's election, this little-known but well-funded protesting arm has beefed up staff and ramped up recruitment of young liberal activists, declaring on its website, "We're not backing down." Determined to salvage Obama's legacy, it's drawing battle lines on immigration, Obamacare, race relations and climate change. With that in mind, what's one to think when Obama makes an overseas trip to meet up with the same exact people President Trump just met with? Yeah. What a sad, sad little man Obama has turned out to be.